Welcome to virtual class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai Education Department. I am Mrs. Akshata Kale and today we will learn English. Okay, now let us move to the lesson. Today's subject is English of Standard 3 and name of the poem is There is the key of the kingdom. Dear children, this is first poem from unit 3. Right? First, we will do one activity. Then, we will proceed to our poem. See, dear children, here you can see some numbers, isn't it? What to do with these numbers? Yes, we have to arrange these numbers from smallest to biggest. Okay, here we can see 5, 1, 9, 4 and 7. You know all these numbers, right? And you know the value of these numbers. Now, we will arrange these numbers from smallest number to biggest number. Isn't it? See this. This is 1. You know, this is the smallest number among given numbers. Right? After 1, 4 is the smaller one. Correct? 1, then 4, then comes 5. Correct? A little bigger one. Then 7, isn't it? The last, here the biggest one is 9. How we arrange the given numbers? From smallest, that is 1, to the biggest, that is 9. Got this? Now, same thing we will follow by taking different examples. Okay? Put the following chains in the proper order from the smallest to the biggest. Here we can see some things you can see here. Seeds, container, house, kitchen, dried chili. Okay, these are given here. What to do here? We have to write them from smallest to the biggest. Okay, first we will watch the pictures of these one. First one, what is that? Seeds. Okay, I will show you seeds. See, these are seeds. Okay, then container. What is the meaning of container? See this. A box in which we can keep the seeds or chilies, etc. Okay, container, box. Then you know the meaning of house. See this. Then kitchen. See, this is the kitchen where mummy prepares food for the people of the house. Correct? Then dried chili. Dried chili means they are red in color. Correct? Green chili and red chili. These are dried chilies. Okay. Now see, here we have to arrange these things in the order, that is from smallest to the biggest. Now see this. These seeds are very small. Correct? So this is, we will give number 1. Okay. We will take this as number 1 because it is very smallest compared to rest all. Right? Yes. What will be the second one? Yes, you are. It is nice. Means you are correct. That is 2. Dried chilies. Now, we can see these seeds inside these chilies. So, they are smaller than these chilies. Isn't it? Then, where we will keep these dried chilies? Inside the container. Right? The container we will keep in kitchen. and kitchen is smaller than our house. Right? First comes seeds, then dried chili, then comes container, then kitchen, then house. What this means? We have arranged all these given materials or things from smallest to the biggest. Okay? See here. We will arrange them. First, seeds. Then, seeds are inside the dried chili. For this, now dried chili we keep inside the container. Right? And where is the container? Container is inside our kitchen. Okay? Can you see here container with the dried chilies? Then where is the kitchen? Kitchen is inside our house. For the students, now we moved from smallest to biggest. I hope you understood about this. Okay, one more example we will try. Again, put the following chains in the proper order from the smallest to the biggest. Okay, why it is called a chain? Because it is connected to one another. Like a, see, this acts like a link. Okay, hyphens. They are connected to each other, so it is called as chains. Okay, here also we will see the pictures of these words. What is this? Shirt. See, this is shirt. Okay, now this is car. Right? Now man with the shirt and pocket, see this. Okay, then highway, you know, a big width road, wide road, it is called highway. Then pen. Okay, this is shirt, car, man. Okay, pocket also is there, and highway, a wide road, then pen. Now, again here we have to arrange them in proper order, that is from smallest to the biggest. Okay, first we will give them numbers. Yes, you know, here smallest is nothing but pen. So, I am going to give one number. Second is shirt, isn't it? Pocket and shirt. Then third, man, correct? Man will sit inside the car and car will run on the highway. Got this? Okay, we will arrange them. See, again I will write one time here the answer. Okay, the first one is pen. Then pen is inserted in the pocket. Can you see here? Inside the pocket pen is there, and then shirt comes. The man is wearing this shirt. Okay. Now man is sitting inside the car. And car is running on the highway. Got this, students? I hope it is clear to you how to move from smallest to biggest. You must know the size of the things given. Okay. Now, we will move to our poem. See, this is our poem of page number 44 from the Balabharati English textbook. Okay, the title is, There is the Key of the Kingdom. You know about the key, the meaning of the key. And kingdom means desh, rajya. Okay. There is the key of the kingdom. First we will read this poem. There is the key of the kingdom. In that kingdom there is a city. See this? In that kingdom there is a city. Means city is smaller than kingdom. In that city, there is a town. Okay? And in that town, there is a street. In that street, there is a lane. Street means sadak. And on that sadak, what is there? Lane means gully. In that lane, there is a yard. Yard means place outside the house or place inside the boundary of the house. Okay. Then in that yard, there is a house. In that house, there is a room. We saw that how kitchen is there inside of a house. Like that. In that house, there is a room. In that room, there is a bed. In that room, there is a bed. Okay, on that bed, there is a basket. And in that basket, there are some flowers. What this year we saw that from biggest to smallest. Right? What we saw here from biggest, that is kingdom, to the smallest, that is flowers in the basket. Isn't it? From the biggest to smallest. Yes. Kingdom is biggest. Inside that city will be there. And inside the city, town is there. And inside the town, street is there. And inside the street, lane is there. And yard is inside the lane. And house is inside the yard. And room is there inside the house. And in that room, bed is there. On the bed, basket is there. And inside the basket, some flowers are there. For this. Now, see this. We will arrange them from biggest to smallest. See this. This is, think this is a kingdom, biggest one, isn't it? Inside the kingdom, city is there, means city is smaller than kingdom. And inside the city, town is there. Okay, town is smaller than city. Now inside the town, street is there. What is there? Street. Okay, and inside the lane is there. Okay, and inside the lane, yard we can see. And inside the yard, house is there. See, this is house. And inside the house, room is there. This is our room. And inside the room, there is a bed. Okay, and on the bed, there is a basket. This is our basket. And inside the basket, there are flowers. Got this? Means we moved from biggest to smallest. Isn't it? I hope you understood. Let us move to the next stanza. Dear children, again you can see here the numbers, correct? Now we are going to arrange these numbers from biggest to smallest. Okay, it is very easy, right? Because you know the value of the numbers. 5, 1, 9, 4, 7. Same numbers I have taken. Okay, now we will arrange them from biggest to smallest. Yes, you know. Correct. 9 is the biggest one among these. After 9, a little small, that is 7. Then comes 5. Correct. Then comes 4. The smallest one is nothing but 1. Isn't it? Here we arrange from biggest to smallest. Okay. Now, we will move to our this poem. Now this is our second stanza of the poem. Here we will read this. Flowers in the basket. Same thing is reversed here. Okay, whatever was there in the first stanza, it is reversed in the second stanza. Okay, see this. Flowers in the basket. Basket on the bed. Bed in the room. Room in the house. House in the yard. Yard in the lane. Lane in the street. Street in the town. Okay. And town in the city. City in the kingdom. And this is the key of the kingdom. Got this, students? See, this is from smallest to biggest, right? Smallest is flowers. Then comes bed, then comes room, then house, yard, then comes lane, then street, town, city, and kingdom. Got this? Means it is given from smallest to biggest. Okay, again we will try to keep them in the order. Okay, by using the rectangles. This is flowers. Okay, flowers. Right? They are in the basket. This is basket. We are going in reverse position. See, from smallest to biggest. Basket is on the bed. Right? Bed is in the room. This is room. Right? Room is in the house. Correct? And house is in the yard. And yard is in the street. Right? Sorry, lane. And lane is in the street. And street is in the town. See, this is town. And town is in the city. See, this is our city. And city is inside the kingdom. Got this? Same thing. We came in reverse. Right? Means we moved from smallest to biggest. Got this? This is all about our poem. In this poem, we have learnt about how to arrange the given things according to their sizes, from smallest to biggest or from biggest to smallest. Isn't it? Okay. Now children, we will move to the exercise part. Okay. Put the following chains in the proper order from the smallest to biggest. You can see here. We will read this first. Again, chain we can see here. This is letter. Letter means alphabets. Word. Okay, word means alphabet. Together they make words. Correct? Here if you take A as a letter, then word example is apple. Now this is bookshop, where we get the books. Story, a single story. Okay, story book. The book is filled with stories. Then it is called a story book. Right? Paragraph. And this is sentence. So many, 2 to 3 sentence or more than that, they make a paragraph. Okay, now we will arrange these given words from smallest to the biggest according to their meanings. Okay, yes, I will write. Otherwise, you pause the video and you write in your notebook and check with my answer. Okay, you can pause here. Okay, I will write the answer. First comes letter. Correct? Then letter together make the word. Words together make sentences. 2 to 3 sentences together make paragraph. 2 to 3 paragraphs make a story. So many stories together make storybook. And we get storybooks in the bookshop. Correct? Okay. Let us move to the next one. See, this is our question. Tail. This is hair. Mountain. Cave. Bear. You know, tail, pooch. Hair. Our hair like this. Okay, hair. Mountain. Pahad. Cave. What we say? Cave. Bogda in Marathi. Okay, you know cave, correct? Where the lion and all that they stay. Gufa, you can say. Okay? And then bear. You know the animal, isn't it? Okay, now again we will try to write this. Again, you can pause the video. You write your answer and check with my answer. Okay? Now I will write here. First one comes hair, correct? Hair is on the tail. Tail, the bear has a tail. And bear is inside the cave, and cave is inside the mountain or below the mountain. Got this? Here also we arrange these from smallest to biggest. One more is there. Grain of corn. Corn ka dana. Makke ka dana. Okay. Field. Kheti. Khet. Sorry. Khet. Plant. Stalk. Sabal to jo makke ka pura ear of corn ko pakda hai wo stalk. And ear of corn. Okay. Bahut sare makke idhar. Now we will arrange. Again, you can pause the video, you write the answer and check with my answer. Smallest to biggest we have to write. Yes, correct. Grain of corn, makki ka ek dana, first one. Right? Then comes ear of corn. Right? Because grain of corn kis mein rehta hai? Ear of corn, bunch mein rehta hai. Then comes stalk, usko hold karta hai wo, ear of corn ko. Okay, then it is attached to the plant, corn plant, then corn plant is in the field. Okay, let us move further. Now, activity is there. Write words that begin with K. Again, here you can pause our video and you can write words that begin with K. Okay, now I will write here. Kite. That begin with K. K-I-T-E. Kite. Next, key. It is in our poem. Key. K-E-Y. Key. Then, king. K-I-N-G. King. Kitten. A baby cat. Right? Kitten. K-I-T-T-E-N. Kitten. Kind. K-I-N-D. Kind. Kitchen. K-I-T-C-H-E-N. Kitchen. Kangaroo. You know the animal, right? K-A-N-G-A-R-O-O. Kangaroo. Kick. K-I-C-K. Kick. I have taken some words from the poem and some from outside. Okay. Next, list the occupations of people in a city. Occupation. Kaam dhanda. What we say? occupation. Okay, now if you see the examples, then you will come to know the meaning of occupation. See this. Who is he? He is a doctor, isn't it? Who is he? He is an engineer. See, these are all occupations. Now, she is a nurse. Next, she is a secretary to the boss. Okay. Next, he is a policeman. These are all are called as occupations. Okay. Next, some more you will see. Who is he? He is a soldier. A waiter. Correct? Painter. See the picture? Okay. He is a barber who cuts our hair. Correct? Barber. Please remember the names. Okay. Soldier, painter, barber, waiter. We can see waiter in the hotels, isn't it? Some more. This is a courier boy. Mechanic who repairs our vehicles. Chef who cooks delicious food. Firefighter. Office worker who works in the office. Teacher, you know her very well, right? Who teaches in the school. See this, beautician. Next, businessman. Next here, policeman. Sweeper. We all see them in our cities, correct? List the different kinds of buildings we see in town. See, this is hospital. You can see different types of buildings. See, this is a hospital and this is a bank, can say. See these skyscrapers we can see in our town, isn't it? See, this is a bank. We can see library. We can see fire station. We can see malls and schools, post office, right? Stock exchange. You can see different types of buildings. Now we will move to types of rooms in a house. Some have small houses, some have big houses, and we have different rooms in our house, right? We will go through them. See, this is living room, or it is called as sitting room. When the guest comes, they sit here. Okay, this is, we can also call as hall. Okay, hall of the house or living room. Go through this picture. This is dining room where we have our food. Lunch, breakfast, dinner, etc. What it is called? Dining room. Okay. Next one is, see this. This is our study room where you sit and study. Correct? That is called as study room. Then this is bedroom where we sleep. Okay. Next is, this is our kitchen. Here our mother prepares food. Correct? And this is bathroom, where we take bath. It helps us to keep our body clean, isn't it? Here we saw different types of rooms inside our house. Okay. Next is different types of flowers. We will go through some of the flowers. Okay. See, this one is rose. You know this. Correct? This is daisy. Please remember the names and try to identify the flowers. Rose, you know. Second one is daisy. See the flower. They are of different colors. Okay, but the name remains same. Next is, this is sunflower. Okay. And this is orchid. Try to identify the flowers along with their names. Okay. This is daffodil. This is lily. Next is chrysanthemum. See these flowers we see in the market. Different colored flowers, correct? They come in different colors. These are called as chrysanthemum. This is tulip. These are tulips. Next, this is for sorcery. See this. Using your imagination, make similar chains of 3 to 5 related things and list them according to their size. Write where each of the things can be formed. We have done so many examples. We have come across with so many examples and we made the chain proper. We arranged the things from the chain from smallest to biggest and from biggest to smallest. Right? You only take some words or some objects, you arrange them in chain and then you keep them in proper order, means from smallest to biggest or from biggest to smallest. Okay. Now next activity. See this, dear children. Here I have shown different pictures of occupations. You have to write here the name of the occupation. What to do here? Write name of the occupation. See, you can write for the first one, painter. Okay, I will not give rest all. You have to identify. Okay? Thank you, children. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you very much for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get the new updated videos.